My name's Ernest and I'm an entrepreneur and public speaker and an author as well.
So where are you based?
What do you mean, like where do I live?
Yeah,
Waterloo.
Is that where you've been based your life and you've done all your business?
No, I started in Catford. Then when I moved out to Waterloo, that's when I started my first business. I moved away from all the troubles.
So, how old were you when you first got into business?
16, going on 17.
So you started pretty young then?
Yeah.
So was it challenging starting at
such
a young age?
Yeah, because I didn't know nothing about business, and business weren't my passion. I only got into it because no one wanted to hire me. So I thought, if no one's going to give me the opportunity to work, I'll go and create my own opportunity. I didn't know nothing about business.
Wow. Then it's strange because some people would use that same mentality and try and get into, you know, maybe some illegitimate ways of making money.
But do you know what it was? Because when I said I moved up from Catford to Waterloo, is that it was a new chapter, fresh start. So I thought, let me get into business. Let me not go down the illegal way. I thought, business or nothing.
So what was your first business then?
It was a delivery and removal company. But the funny thing about the delivery and removal company, I didn't plan it. It wasn't an idea, no nothing. I went to a business event and everyone was talking about business, this, I own this, and with me, I've got pride, and there was a lot of females around, so I couldn't say, oh, I don't have a business. But I just said, yeah, I have a delivery removal company. And some guy said, yeah, I might need your service, I'm moving offices. But I thought to myself, oh, this time I didn't have a business, I didn't have no van. That was the first thing that came to my head. So once I got his number, he took my number, he called me. So what I did when I went on Gumtree, and I looked for a man with a van, and once I found a man with a van, called him and I said, yeah, my work is ready whenever you're ready. And from there, I'll start doing it. Men in a van, when I come to look for work, and I went to look for men in a van, but I had enough money.
So you were literally
the middleman.
So yeah. You'll find a client and then just add a markup price to it.
Yeah. So if they tell me their price is £40, I say 55. I just keep getting my cut.
So you literally spoke your business into existence.
Put it that way.
Let's find out a bit more about your history and, you know, what kind of background you come from.
I grew up in Catford, got kicked out of centre, I was on probation and all sorts. And everyone's, like all my close friends, everyone started going to jail. If you're not getting jailed, they're getting killed. You know how the knife crime is in the Southeast. So I thought to myself, I want to be more, I want to achieve something, I want to make my mum proud. So once we moved out of Catford to Waterloo, I thought, cool. Let me get a job, a little 9-to-5, so I can provide for my family. But obviously, because I didn't have no work experience, no nothing, no one wanted to hire me. So I thought, let me go down the business way. So that's how it is.
And how hard has it been, kind of, not having that kind of steady income and just investing in yourself?
Yeah. Is that just leverage? Is that, when people get into business, they always think they need to find an investor. They need to take out a loan to pay for office, admin also. But you really don't. My first business, like I told you, I started in my room. All I needed was credit on my phone. Then from there, when I made enough money, I invested into my other business. And from there, I invested into my other business. So at the end of the month, that was 5 different streams of income. So you don't really need any investors, or you don't really need any help. All you need to do is research. Everything's online nowadays. So just do a lot of research. You've got to be dedicated.
In terms of like where your business is now, where are you guys? What
are
you guys doing?
I recently launched a new business called Ernest Associates, and that's basically we do wealth management, marketing and branding, model management, and also web designing and app development as well. So what I'm trying to do is expand my business into other things. Let's see the way Virgin Group done it. They've got Virgin this, Virgin that. That's what I'm trying to do with Ernest Associates.
You trying to have your 7 streams of income.
Yeah. So before, I started with a company called ECA, the ECA Group. And ECA stands for Ernest Kwasi Asoerak. And I had 8 different companies, ECA Marketing, ECA Estates, ECA Design. So I had 8 different streams of income. But the thing is, my goal was, when I got into business, at first I didn't really want to do business, but when I got into business, like 2 years later, my goal was to have an office in Canary. But by 19, I had 2 offices in Canary, and I thought to myself, yeah, let me start hiring my friends, give them something to do with their lives. And obviously, I started hiring the wrong person that came around, started stealing money from my clients, and I lost it all. So now I'm starting with Ernest Associates.
Talk us through that journey of how you went from somebody who was trying to apply for a job and getting rejected to somebody who had 2 offices in Canary Wharf.
And you know what it was? I read something online, and it's, if you want to be something, act like it. If you hang around with 3 broke friends, you're going to be the 4th broke person. If you hang around with 5 unsuccessful people, you're going to be the 6th failure, right? So what I did was, I stopped talking to my friends, stopped hanging around with the people I used to hang around with. So I started going to a lot of business events. And you heard of the saying, 75% of success happens by you just showing up. So I started showing up to every business event. I changed my appearance from trackies and hoodies to suits, 3 pieces, just tried to fit in. So when you do things like that, you meet new people, like you network with successful people, and with people like that, they open doors for you. So certain people start opening new doors for me, introduce me to other people. That's how I just started building my clientele. It's like, go to every event. When you go to the events, you meet new people. You become friends with them. Let's say if me and you met each other like that. If you need a website, you're gonna go online. Then someone's gonna give you one of them high prices. If you met at a business event, you tell me what you do. I tell you what I do. From there, we become friends. I do website. If you need a website, you can call me, and I can give you a good price, a good discount. Or if you need something and I know someone that might be able to help you, I'll just say, yeah, a friend of mine needs this and that. So networking, there's power in networking. So from there, I just started networking. When I had my eco-marketing, I didn't know nothing about marketing. I just went to network with everyone that does marketing. It's like, I'll talk to them, I'll act like, do you know what it is? Fake it till you make it. And act like it. You want to be a businessman? Act like it. So I was acting like I had a successful marketing company. So I didn't approach them like I needed their service. When you approach someone like you need their service, that's when they start selling their products. They start selling whatever. But if you act like you know your stuff, you know what you're doing, they start talking, they start giving you tips. Guys, I'll do it this way. But then this is the way I do, because everyone loves to show up. So they just say, well, I made this amount of money because I've done it this way, I've done it that. It's like they're giving me the full service without me paying for it, without even them realizing. So that's how I just started learning of other people. Then I put everything that I learned to my business.
Yeah. So, my thing is that when you
they open new doors, yeah. They introduce you to other people as well. That might come in handy, not now, but they might come in handy in the future. So that's the power of networking.
Spoke about business.
Yeah, because like I said, yeah, when I had that 2 offices in Canary and I started hiring other like people that weren't trustworthy, so they start stealing money from my clients. It's like every month rent was due and I was seeing money's going out but money's not coming in. It didn't make no sense. And I started doing a lot of, like, I started checking in my company. I started seeing people are stealing money. So I started losing all my clients. So I lost everything. And obviously I had an argument with my family, my mum. And obviously I moved out my house without thinking. So let's say 1 minute I felt like I was on top. Next minute I was sleeping in the park. I was homeless. So I was going through a lot for the past 7 months. Is that everything got taken away from me, my family, my money, my business that I worked hard for. To me, sleeping in the park. So let's say for the past 11 months, plus I had a kid as well, so too much stress. So I went from having it all to sleeping in the park to working. So once I got a thing here, when I got everything together, I got myself a little place to stay, everything. Then I started doing business. I got back on my grind, but the fear of failing kept me up all night. So I was taking Pro Plus, drinking Red Bull, drinking alcohol to stay awake, because I was scared to go like going back to losing it all again. So all of that, like days without sleeping, or just weeks, just weeks working, no break. Next thing I knew, I was in a hospital. Then from there, because I was shocked that I was in a hospital, so I couldn't speak. So the doctor thought I was crazy, I was mental. So I got sent to Moseley, a mental hospital. So I got they put me on section 7 at 72 hours. Then after they put me on section 2, that's 28 days. And they try and put me on section 3. That's 6 months. So they try and put me on section 3. That's 6 months in a mental hospital. My problem was, I'm not mental. I just was scared to go with that, scared to fail. So I'll do anything. I didn't know the limit, my body in it. So I just stayed up for weeks doing work. Because I wanted to get back where I was. I wanted to pick up from where I left, like get all my business. So through all of that, taking pills, not sleeping, my body's tired, I end up in a mental hospital mostly. When I was sitting in Moseley, I saw it as in there's nothing I can physically do. I can act, I can go crazy, trying to fight everyone. That's just going to make things worse for me. So in my mind, I was thinking to myself, because I've got a positive mindset. I wasn't thinking about now, I was thinking about the future. I was thinking, when I come out, this is what I'm going to do. I was writing down my goals, my plans. So I was trying to keep a positive mind frame. Like Steve Jobs said, you can't connect the dot looking in the future, you can only connect the dots looking back. So me sitting in a mental hospital, trying to find something positive, didn't make no sense. I was thinking long term, nothing made sense. I was thinking to myself, when I come out, this is what I'm gonna do, this is the route I'm gonna go down. So now looking back, I was thinking, I'm glad that happened, because what that did, that helped me relax, that helped me calm down. Because when I was in there was nothing I can do. When I'm offside, no one can physically tell me what to do or stop me from doing work. So I was just doing everything at once, and I was missing out on opportunities, losing out on money, because I couldn't think straight. I was up for days, taking pills, drinking Red Bull energy drink. And when I want to sleep, I take sleeping pills. Then an hour later, I'll take Pro-Plus to keep me up. But when I was sitting in the mental hospital, I was thinking, when I come out, this is what I'm gonna do. I have to do this for my son. Thinking about providing a better future for my son just helped me stay strong. As soon when I came out, that's when I launched Ernest Associates, spoke to a couple investors, sold a share for £50,000, 25%. So when I look back at it, I thought, yeah, I needed that break. So I just see it as in, I took a break.
There's going to be some young people that are listening to this that are in similar situations to where you were, where they haven't necessarily got a job, or they have their visions in their head. They might have chosen themselves. What kind of advice would you give for them?
Is that the worst thing you can do when you're getting through a situation like that is sit down and point fingers. Because life is hard, we all know, but if you point fingers, expect opportunities to come and come out of nowhere to give you opportunity, it's never gonna happen. So stop sitting down thinking, I wish I can, stop wishing and start doing. Go out and make things happen. If they don't wanna open a door for you, create your own opportunity, build your own doors. Don't sit down and wait for the window of success to open for you. Go out and make things happen. That's how I saw things. I didn't want to sit down. When I was homeless, I didn't want to sit down and think, oh, because of those friends I'm homeless, because of this I'm homeless. Me saying that is not going to change my situation. It's that write your own story. Go out, create your own opportunity. Only you can do it. When you look at other people, successful people, not all of them came from a rich background. Everyone has to suffer. Everyone had to go through the struggle. It's like I tell my partners, it's not about the knockdown. It's not about what you're going through, it's what you do after the knockdown. That's what defines who you are. So people can't judge you because you're down. I think they can start judging you after the knockdown, is what you do. So if you fail, you lose everything, and you decide to point fingers, people will call you a failure. But if you get knocked down, you lose everything, and you work yourself back to it, you work hard, and you get everything back, no one can talk for you. And a good thing about not having it as well and hitting rock bottom is the only way is up. And when you make your way to the top, nothing's given to you. So let's say, God forbid, you do fail again, what you did to make that, to get back to the top, what is you gather the recipe to success. So if you do fail, you've got the recipe, you've got the blueprint. But when you wait for opportunities and people give you handouts, when times are hard, you don't know how to build everything again because everything was given to you. But when you work hard for yourself and you do everything yourself, no one can stop you. Because let's say the web designing, with web designing, when it comes to web designing, coding, it's not a gift, it's not a talent, it's something that you learn. So if someone knows how to do a web design and all sorts, then learn how to do it. It's not something that you're born with, it's not a gift, it's not a talent that you're given. What I did, I didn't have money. When I was starting my marketing company, I didn't have enough money. So what I did, I was trying to get a web developer to do my website. It's just the price was too high. But with me, it's not like I'm a stubborn person. If someone knows how to do something and they're making money off it, I'll think to myself, why can't I do that? I'll go and research. I'll try and put a business plan together. So what I did is I went online, I learned how to code, do design website, and I done my own website. And everyone was asking me, oh, who done your website? Who done this? But then again, I couldn't tell them, oh, it was me, because they'll start asking for the friend discount. That's what I'm saying. Oh yeah, I know one company, because I know you, I can get a little discount for you. But this time it was me that was doing it. So I turned that into a business. So all my companies was indoors. Sales and marketing, branding, social media marketing, web design, apps, everything was indoors. It's like money comes in, but money doesn't go out. That's how I built, that's how I started my company.
All
by myself. Is that like a friend told me, his name is Junior Ogoyemi. He wrote a book on how to be a student entrepreneur. Is once you have a laptop and Wi-Fi or internet, you have a business. That's all you need nowadays. Once you have a laptop and internet, you have a business. Everything's online now. Because let's say if people are sleeping in this country, there's people awake in America. Website never sleeps. Everything's online. Once you have one thing, promote, just put it out there on the internet. It's just about the way you market. So once you get someone's, let's say affiliate product, you sell someone else's product until you have enough money to make your own product, then you start your business. All you need is a website. All you need is the internet and a laptop. And just Google, learn everything. Online courses, online this, online that. Don't wait for people to come and give you everything. No one's gonna come and save you, I'm telling you. So you have to go out and make things happen yourself. If you don't, you're just gonna be 40, signing on and doing nothing with your life, looking back, pointing fingers. Is that once you're from 16, 21, is the right time to do everything now. You don't have a mortgage to pay, you don't have big bills to pay, you don't have a family, like kids and wife to raise, you might have a kid, but there's nothing stopping you. This is the time to struggle and grind. So once you're 25, you're good, you're financial, like, you've got that financial freedom. Nah. Forget the Instagram pictures. Forget the next person with an LV belt, with a Gucci belt. When you see that, let's say popping bottles, driving their cars, the rentals. Some people will see that and think, I need to go uni, not to study, just for the uni loan. All of that will just mess you up. It will mess up your credit. It's like you're chasing the money, but you're not willing to work for it. But what I've learned is, forget about the money, forget about success, forget about the business award, put in the work and all of that will follow without even you realizing.
Okay, so a few things I want to ask you. Could you just tell us every single thing that you're doing at the moment so that people know exactly?
I have a wealth management company, so I'm trying to turn that into a hedge fund. So basically, it's like an investment company. So if you invest, let's say, £5,000 to £10,000, we're not just going to invest into buying shares, stocks, we're going to invest in lands. We're going to look for startup companies that needs investment. We're going to invest in everything and make sure you get good return every month. I've got a marketing and branding company. So we market, plus social media company. So we do all the social media, get you new followers that basically create, like get your website out there online. And also, yeah, all that comes under Ernest Associates. So we have a modeling company, web designing, app development company. So I do motivational speeches, I'm a motivational speaker, I give speeches, I do one-on-one coaching. Like if you need help with depression, whatever you need help with, let's say if it's depression, personal life goals, happiness, or business, I can help you. I can even help you write your business plan, help you get your business out, help you get an investor. From there, I can help you with everything. I've got two books out as well. So, that so much. I think there's so much that up top, I just can't remember.
Yes, I think everybody would want to read the book. So
tell us
what your books are, where we can get
them. Is that all on Amazon? But do you know what it is? I don't want to put that out there because I've got two new books I want to promote in it.
When you get that book, you send it to
Amazon. So that. Oh yeah, I sent it to you.
Yeah, yeah. So do you want to kind of give like a teaser as to what the books are going to be about?
And basically, the book is just going to, I'm just going to write down about my journey. Is that people can come and say, yeah, I started from nothing, I'm successful, I have money now, this, that. Or, yeah, my parents invested in me, I have money. Ooh. But not all of us, some of us start business, it doesn't work. Certain people start up 10 companies and they all fail. With me now, I can tell you, I started from nothing and I made something out of nothing. I got it and I lost it all. And when I said I lost it all, I'm not saying I just lost my businesses, lost everything. Then I lost all my money, lost all my companies, fell out with my family. I was homeless, came back, worked hard, got some of my companies back, and I lost it again, end up in a mental hospital. And boom, came back and I launched a new company, got £50,000 in investment. And also I've won 10 business awards. I have 11 different business award nominations as well. So I know what I'm talking about. I'm not going to tell you, oh, I started a business, you're going to be successful in a couple. No, I've made money, I've lost money. To the point I was homeless, end up in a mental home, to just getting everything back. So that all of that is going to be in my book.
In the book.
In, like, let's say in September, just look out for it.
So, last question. You're a very ambitious person, I can see in you. I know you're going to be successful 100%, but where do you see yourself in, let's say, 5 years' time?
5 years' time, 5 years, I'm going to be what, 26? 5 years' time, well, my goal is people say they want to be a billionaire.
Where do you see yourself in 5 years?
5 years' time, let's say, I want to make 20 million. But by me saying I want to make 20 million, I'm not trying to brag or try to be big-headed. I'm saying minimum I want to make is 20 million. But I'm not trying to brag or be big-headed. By me saying 20 million is me aiming high, like having big goals and big dreams. I'm not saying I'm definitely going to make 20 million, but by me aiming high, I might make 5 million, 2 million, 5 million. But in my mind, I won't realize that I made 2 or 5 million because I'm focused on 20 million. So in a 5 years time, I'll probably be making 6 million, but I won't care because my goal is 20 million. So I'm saying, make sure you set your standards very high. Because if you don't reach your goal, you're going to look back and think, raw, I've come a long way. But that's what I'm saying, 20 million and successful businesses.
Yeah.